So here's the answer. The first one is always equivalent to the string S. Remember, what it means to use the colon when there's nothing on the left side means start from the beginning, and when there's nothing on the right side means go all the way to the end. So if there's nothing on either side, that's selecting the entire string. So the second one's a little trickier, but this also always has the same value as the string S. And the reason is we have the original string S and we're concatenating to it the string S index 0 colon negative 1 plus 1. Well, negative 1 plus 1 has the value 0. When we index from 0 colon 0, that's an empty string. And the reason that's an empty string is because we're starting from 0 and we're stopping just before 0. There are no characters between 0 and 0, so that's an empty string. Adding the empty string to itself leaves the string empty. And the interesting thing about this is this works even when S is an empty string. If S was an empty string, S index 0, that would produce an error. It's trying to select the first character from S, and there's no first character since S was an empty string. But S index 12 colon 12, even though there's no 12th character of S, since there are no characters between there, it's okay that S doesn't have them. That's going to evaluate to the empty string. So the third one is also always equivalent to S. It's selecting from the beginning of the string, position 0, all the way to the end. Again, as we saw here, even if S has no characters, this is still okay. It will give us the empty string. If S has any characters, it will give us all the characters in S. The fourth one is not equivalent, and this might be a little surprising. It sounds like, well, it's selecting all the characters from the beginning to the end, because negative 1 is the index of the last character in S. But remember that the selection stops before the last character. So what this will give us every character besides the last one. So let's see that in the Python interpreter. We're going to print S index colon negative 1, and this will give us all the characters except for the last one. So the final one is the most surprising, that this actually is always equivalent to S. It's equivalent even if S has fewer than 3 characters. So the first part is selecting all the characters from the beginning up to position 3, not including position 3. And then we're concatenating that with all of the characters of S from position 3 to the end. If S has less than 3 characters, well, this is going to be empty. There are no characters from position 3 to the end. But that's okay. We're going to add the empty string to the characters before position 3. So here's how that works in the Python interpreter. We'll do S from position beginning to index 3 and add that to S index 3 to the end. That produces the same string. And if we do this with a shorter string, let's initialize T to be the string high. We can print from T to position 3 plus from T from position 3 to the end. We don't get an error. We get the string high out. So this indexing subsequence is very resilient. It works even when we index positions that don't exist in the string. This is different from when we were doing indexing of particular positions by themselves. If we did index T index 3, that will give us an error because there's no character at position 3.